Just a few years ago, rockets and space travel used to be the concern purely of government agencies. But in recent times, many private companies started investing in space tech. One of them is Relativity Space, and they claim to 3D print rockets to make space travel cheaper for humans. So let's discuss everything related to Relativity Space and how are they going to compete with the Falcon 9 in today's video of DiscoverZen. Relativity Space is an American aerospace manufacturing company headquartered in Los Angeles, California. It was founded in 2015 by Tim Ellis and Jordan Noon. Relativity Space is developing manufacturing technologies, launch vehicles, and rocket engines for commercial orbital launch services. The company's vision is at the forefront of inevitable shift towards software-defined manufacturing. By fusing 3D printing, artificial intelligence, and autonomous robotics, they expect to be a pioneer in the factory of the future. Their long-term goal is to upgrade humanity's industrial base on Earth and on Mars. According to the company, in the early days of a settlement on different planets, intelligent automation and lightweight compact 3D printing are absolutely fundamental technologies needed to quickly establish a new society with scarce resources. In order to make such large 3D printed components, Relativity Space has created a system named Stargate, which it claims is the world's largest 3D printer of metals. The system is based on directed energy deposition, which uses laser beams to melt metal wire layer by layer into precise and complex structures that have minimal joints and parts. The company aims at 3D printing at least 95% of their launches, including the engines. The company plans to eventually 3D print a complete launch vehicle within 60 days. Relativity Space also built its first engine named Aeon 1. It is designed to produce 15,500 pounds of thrust or 68,975 newtons of force at sea level and 25,400 pounds of thrust or 86,775 newtons in a vacuum. The engine is powered by liquid natural gas and liquid oxygen. It is made out of a proprietary 3D printed alloy. It is printed by a selective laser sintering and assembled from fewer than 1,000 parts. By March 2018, Relativity Space had completed more than 300 test firings of its Aeon 1 engine using the E3 test facility at NASA's Stennis Space Center. The company also built its rocket named Terran 1. It is an expendable two-stage launch vehicle powered by liquid natural gas and liquid oxygen. Relativity said that they design, build, and operate the rocket to provide their customers the most responsive and affordable small satellite launch service on the market. The Terran 1 vehicle is 35 meters or 115 feet in height by 2.3 meters or 7.5 feet in diameter and uses 10 Aeon engines, 9 Aeon 1 engines on the first stage and 1 Aeon vacuum engine on the second stage. The company prints all structures and major engine components using proprietary printable metal alloys, which in future may lead to a dramatic simplified manufacturing process when compared to traditional fabrication methods. This will make it possible to shrink vehicle build and integration timelines down to just about 60 days. Terran 1's fairing volume accommodates a variety of payload designs and configurations, including dedicated launch for single payloads and constellations, as well as multi-manifest and ride configurations. Terran 1 is designed for a mission duration of up to 2.5 hours as a standard service. The rocket is priced at $12 million per launch and is designed to carry 1,250 kilograms to low Earth orbit. That puts Terran 1 in the middle of the US launch market, in between Rocket Lab's Electron and SpaceX Falcon 9 in both price and capability. Now let's talk about their new rocket named Terran R, which they expect will take over SpaceX's Falcon 9. According to the CEO Ellis, Terran R will be capable of lifting nearly 20 times as much payload as Terran 1, with Relativity targeting a rocket capable of launching more than 20,000 kilograms to low Earth orbit. That would be near the 22,800 kilograms that SpaceX says its Falcon 9 rockets can launch. In talks with CNBC, Ellis declined to disclose what price launch Relativity expects for Terran R, but He said that Relativity plans to be competitive with other offerings. SpaceX advertises Falcon 9 rocket launches with a $62 million price tag, with Musk's company saying each rocket cost about $28 million to launch. The CEO also highlighted SpaceX's work on reusability, as informing Relativity's approach to Terran R, which he expects will be fully reusable. SpaceX's Falcon 9 rockets are partially reusable, meaning that the company lands the first stage, also known as the booster, and often recovers the rocket's nose cone. But SpaceX does not recover Falcon 9's second stages, a feat Relativity aims to pull off by 3D printing designs which wouldn't be possible with traditional manufacturing. The company also expects to print far more exotic and traditionally difficult to manufacture materials that make both first and second stage reusability much better than any other rocket. Now let's look at the timeline of publicly announced launch contracts for Relativity Space. In June 2020, Relativity Space announced that they had signed a new launch contract with Iridium. The contract included up to 6 dedicated launches to deploy ground-spare satellites to low Earth orbit, LEO, for Iridium's next constellation on Relativity's Terran 1 vehicle. According to Susie McBride, Iridium's COO, the satellite communication provider chose to partner with Relativity Space because of their flexible launch capability and the company's ability to launch one satellite at a time. If we look at the timeline, we can expect launches to begin no earlier than 2023. In September 2019, Relativity Space and Momentus Space announced their launch service agreement at the 2019 World Satellite Business Week in Paris. This agreement stated that Relativity's Terran 1 launch vehicles will carry Momentus Vigoride Space Tug Service vehicles into orbit. The contract is for 6 missions. In May 2019, the company signed a contract with Spaceflight Industries, a satellite rideshare and mission management provider, to launch Spaceflight's dedicated SmallSat rideshares. The terms of the deal were not disclosed, however, it was shared that the contract included one launch of Relativity's Terran 1 rocket in the third quarter of 2021, with an option of unspecified number of additional launches. Relativity Space publicly announced their contract with Moo Space in April 2019. It is expected that the company will launch a Moo Space satellite to low Earth orbit in the second half of 2022, aboard Relativity's Terran 1 rocket. On April 5, 2019, Relativity Space announced its first signed contract. The contract was with Telesat, the Canadian telecom satellite operator. The terms of this contract were not specified, but it did include multiple launches of the Terran 1. Lockheed Martin announced on October 16, 2020, that it would launch a cryogenic liquid hydrogen management demonstration mission on Terran 1. Lockheed Martin also specified that the launch will make use of its Momentus Vigoride orbital transfer vehicle to house the cryogenic payload. The announcement came 2 days after NASA announced the recipients of the Tipping Point Awards. Overall, Relativity Space has a vision of 3D printed, fully reusable rockets as the inevitable technology we need to build humanity's industrial base on Mars. This goal is very similar to Musk's dream of making humanity a multi-planetary species by establishing settlements on the Red Planet. CEO of the company, Ellis, believes Relativity and SpaceX can be two companies leading into a new era of exploration. So, this was all about Relativity and their future rockets using 3D printers. Now let's discuss the most reliable rocket ever made, the Falcon 9. Actually, we should go ahead and talk about that on a different episode of DiscoverZen.